Meanwhile, the security situation in Afghanistan continues to remain tense. Despite the ongoing peace procedures, Taliban has escalated attacks on Afghan security forces and civilians, causing more atrocities and bloodshed. As a result, Afghan government too has now adopted an offensive posture against Taliban and has launched counter-terrorism operations against the group. Recently, Afghan government launched an airstrike in western Afghanistan that killed multiple people, including both Taliban militants and civilians. This incident comes as the second phase of US Taliban peace deal is moving forward, a report.
While the Taliban has ramped up attacks against Afghan security forces and civilians in Afghanistan, Afghan government too has been blamed for irresponsibly targeting innocent civilians in their strikes against Taliban insurgents. Recently, a government airstrike killed at least 14 people in Afghanistan's western Herat province, including women and children. Witnesses say that hundreds of people had gathered in Herat's Adras Khan district to welcome home a former Taliban militant freed from jail when aircraft pounded the gathering. A day earlier, another airstrike struck the area of Herat province that killed at least 45 people, including Taliban insurgents and civilians. Acting Defense Minister Asadullah Khalid denied the allegations and said that the six Taliban militants were killed in Herat airstrike. Ministry of Defense said it was investigating allegations of civilian casualties in attacks by Afghan forces in the area and would soon make the findings public.
The Afghan air forces should have been more careful, or rather the Afghan government should have been more careful in using the air force. But these things have happened before. These things have happened when the Americans have used drones and drone strikes to try to neutralize militants, and there have been civilian casualties, what we call collateral damage. That was also very wrong, should not have happened. But suddenly the United States seems to be hypercritical on this because it wants to exit Afghanistan. What happened was, as you have rightly asked me, that the Afghan government also has now become rigid. It has now decided that a soft position vis-a-vis the Taliban is just not working. They are being taken advantage of, and therefore they have hardened their positions and their tactics have also hardened. And as a result of this, while Taliban fighters also died, civilians also died. I think the Afghan government should be careful in basically calibrating their particular strategy.
The US Special Representative for Afghanistan Reconciliation, Zalmay Khalilzad, condemned the airstrike and said that photos and eyewitnesses' accounts suggest many civilians, including children, were killed. The diplomat also slammed the Taliban Islamist movement for continuous attacks that resulted in large number of civilian casualties. He urged all sides to contain the violence and to immediately start intra-Afghan negotiations. The progress on the intra-Afghan talks for mutual peace agreement has been at a standstill due to complications with the prisoner swap that is laid out as precondition for negotiations. The American deal with the Taliban called for the release of up to 5,000 Taliban prisoners in return for 1,000 Afghan security forces held by the insurgents. However, Afghan authorities have refused to release 592 Taliban prisoners who are deemed dangerous and are accused of serious crimes. Meanwhile, in a major development, Afghanistan's Office of National Security Council has revealed that, in defiance of their commitments not to rejoin the war, a number of Taliban prisoners who were released from the Afghan government jails have reintegrated their colleagues on the battlefields.
This system of incentives that existed was perfect for the Taliban because it was a low-risk strategy. If you fight, you can die, but if you don't die, you are taken prisoner, you will live to fight another day, because after some time, the so-called well-wishers of the Afghan government will persuade the Afghan government to let them go. This is become so endemic, and this bad faith shown by the Taliban and the Taliban fighters has contributed to the Afghan government hardening its stance.
The Taliban's recent attacks have taken a heavy toll on Afghan forces. According to Tolo News, an Afghanistan-based media organization, more than 250 Afghan security force members were killed and over 300 more were wounded in 220 attacks staged by the Taliban over the past 3 weeks in 11 provinces of the country. Civilians are bearing the brunt of this deadly conflict from both the sides, as Security Council has accused the Taliban of carrying out 44 attacks and killing or injuring 24 civilians every day in the country since earlier this year.
They have targeted the Hazaras because they have Shias. They have targeted pregnant women in the wards. So it's not just collateral damage where civilians die. It is the specific targeting of a specific ethnic group by the Taliban. And when we say civilian casualties, it has a tendency to obfuscate that.
The country's conflict is back into full-fledged bloodletting after a brief period of hope that the deal between the United States and the Taliban would open the way for negotiations between the two Afghan sides. Although in the peace deal, the Taliban pledged to prevent Afghanistan's territory from being used by terrorist forces, this constant wave of attacks in Afghanistan has once again raised the concerns about the country's future.